Markets with David Modell. Today I wanted to give you an introduction to the stochastic indicator. And it could be an indicator that might tell you, or at least give you an indication of when you might consider buying a stock, and also when you might want to sell it. So let's take a look. This is an example of the stochastic indicator. And the black line is the stochastic line, okay? And the red line is the 3-day moving average of the black line. And so if the black line is a little too choppy for you, it might be a little confusing, the red line is kind of a smoothed out version of the black line. But mainly I focus on the black line, the stochastic line, and it's an overbought and oversold indicator, okay? And so if this bottom line here represents zero, and the line never goes below zero, this top line represents 100, and it never goes above 100, all right? This dotted line is 50, that's the midline, and that means that the price is, you know, about average, where it normally would be. This is 20, and that represents oversold. So if the black line goes below 20, or this line, that means that the stock is possibly cheap and worth buying, because you want to buy at a low price, of course. This line over here is 80, and that represents overbought, which means that if the black line goes above this line here, that means the stock might be expensive, okay? And so you might not want to buy it if it's overbought. And if you already own it, you might consider selling if it goes above, selling your shares if it goes above that line. All right. Now, what a lot of people do is they don't buy right when the black line goes below 20 into oversold territory. They don't buy immediately. They wait until it goes into oversold territory or below 20, and then they wait until it goes back up out of oversold territory. In other words, when it comes back up above 20, that's when they buy. Okay, so let's take a look at some examples. This is Sprint. This is the daily candlestick chart, and I'm using stockcharts.com, which is a free website with stock charts. And now, as you can see, stochastics are not always the most exciting indicator. You might go months without a buy signal, okay? And so you have to have a lot of patience sometimes for stochastics. But as you can see on this chart, one time it went, you know, the black line went into oversold territory, and then if you had bought right when it popped back up or crossed above the oversold line, you know, if it went back up above 20, if you had bought there, you would have enjoyed a really big run-up. You would have done really well. And some people, they might sell their shares when it, you know, the line goes above 80 into overbought territory. You can do that, or you can hold on for longer. In this case, you would have wanted to hold on for longer, for sure. This is Best Buy, and in all this time, there are only two buy signals. But if you had used these signals, you would have done well. The black line went into oversold territory and then popped back up out of oversold territory right here. And if you had bought, then you would have enjoyed, and held, you would have enjoyed a really nice run-up. And here's another. Recently, there was another, you know, went down into oversold and then back up above 20. And then if you had bought right there, it might be too early to tell, but so far it seems to be going up. So it seems to be doing well. Here's Panera Bread, and we have three possible buy signals here. It went into overbought territory here, but again, this is an example of how you don't necessarily want to buy right when it goes into overbought territory, because it can stay in overbought territory for a long time, and you could have a lot of downward price action during that time. So it came up above, okay, out of overbought right here, and if you had bought there, you would have enjoyed a run up here. And then it went below and then above here again, and if you had bought right there, you would have enjoyed a sizable run up there. And then here's another one. It went below and then back up above 20 here, and if you had bought there, so far it's a decent run up. Okay, so those are just a few examples to consider. Don't let any one indicator tell you what to do, when to buy, or, you know, know when not to buy. It's just one indicator of many that you can look at to help you make decisions. So if you like this video, please give this video a thumbs up on YouTube and leave comments. And also please subscribe to my YouTube channel. That way you can receive the latest updates on my financial educational videos. And if you have questions or you just want to put together a trading plan, which you definitely should have, you can email me anytime at davidmodell@gmail.com. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll talk to you soon.